Hello students, this video is for class 6 physical science. In this video I will continue with the chapter that I have started with you people, that is elements, compounds and mixtures. Okay, so in my previous video I have done the separation techniques of the mixture, that is we all know that the mixture is a combination or it is a mixture of physical substances. Those substances can be easily separated. Okay, so that we are going to know that what are the separation techniques. In the previous video we have gone through some of the separation techniques, so in this video also we will go for the rest of the separation techniques. Okay, so how can we separate this? So here in page number 63 you just see that we know that iron is attracted towards a magnet. We all know that cobalt and nickel are also attracted towards magnet. So these substances, this iron, cobalt, nickel, these are attracted towards magnet, and that's why they're termed as magnetic substances. So what are magnetic substances? The substances which are attracted towards magnet, like iron, cobalt, nickel, these are the magnetic substances. Okay. So the next is that, so when iron is mixed with any other non-magnetic solid materials like sand, then iron can be easily separated by using a magnet. When a magnet is brought near such a mixture, only iron particles are attracted and gets attached to the poles of the magnet. This way iron is easily separated from the sand. A strong magnet such as electromagnet is used in the industry to separate scrap iron from the heap of waste materials. So this is the thing, that suppose a mixture of sand and iron particle is taken. Now we want to separate the sand and the iron particle. Now what, how we will do it? We will take a magnet. We will take a magnet and we will move the magnet. Okay, we will move the magnet over the mixture. Okay, so when we are moving the magnet over the mixture, what we can see, these are iron particles. These are getting attracted towards the poles of the magnet. Okay, so in this way we can separate the iron particles from the mixture. Understood? So in case of huge industry, the strong magnet, that is electromagnet, is required. Why? To separate the iron particles or iron heap from the other waste. Okay. So this is the thing. Now next we will move on to the next topic. You can see in page number 63, that is symbol, formula and valency. That we will see. So next we will move on to symbol, formula and valency.
A compound, which is a substance consisting of two or more elements which combine chemically
molecule. Understood? Next, the molecules of a particular compound can be broken down into its constituent elements. Obviously, like H2. This is a molecule of a compound. Now we can break it down to hydrogen and oxygen. These are the elements which combine to form this compound. So we can break it down to form the element or to get the elements. So a molecule of a particular compound has all the characteristics, properties of that compound. So a water molecule, okay, we have all the characteristics as of water. Okay. So a molecule is formed when two or more atoms combine chemically in a definite proportion. The number of each atom in a molecule can be determined by analysis in the laboratory. Below we have listed some compounds and the elements present in each of its molecule. Next is the name of the compounds. First of all, next is that next categories are the name of the atoms present, name of the atoms of the elements present in a number of atoms of the elements present in each molecule. First, you can see hydrogen gas, which is not a compound, it is an element. So, obviously, it is formed of hydrogen element only and two hydrogen atoms forming one molecule of hydrogen. Next, oxygen gas, this is also not a compound, it is an element formed of oxygen. Two atoms of oxygen forms one molecule of oxygen. Next, chlorine gas, which is an element only, chlorine, formed of two atoms, one molecule formed of two atoms of chlorine. Next, iodine, which is another element, so forms of iodine. Another thing is that two iodine atoms forms one molecule of iodine. Next is water, which is a compound formed of hydrogen and oxygen. One oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms combine to form one molecule of water. Next, hydrogen chloride, which is a compound. Elements are hydrogen and chlorine. One hydrogen atom and one chlorine atom combine to form hydrogen chloride. Next, carbon dioxide. Obviously, elements present are carbon and oxygen. One carbon atom and two oxygen atom combine chemically to form carbon dioxide. Quicklime. Elements present are calcium and oxygen. One calcium atom, one oxygen atom combine to form calcium oxide. Next, sugar. What are the elements present in it? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. 12 carbon atoms, 22 hydrogen atoms and 11 oxygen atoms combine to form one sugar molecule. But the names of elements and compounds are often quite big. Scientists don't use such big names when they represent these elements. They have some shortcut. Those are termed as the symbols. Those shortcut are termed as the symbols. So here I am keeping this video to this much. In the next video, I will continue with the chapter. Thank you.